The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, ericsfamilybbq.com.
Eric's Family Barbecue has arrived and is simply the best barbecue in Arizona. Come satisfy your taste buds with meats that are smoked over mesquite wood and sides that are made with fresh ingredients and tons of love. They have the best, juiciest brisket, pulled pork, rib, sausage, turkey, or everyone's favorite, the Pitmaster Sampler that includes all the meat and four sides, mac and cheese, potato salad, coleslaw, corn, or beans, yum. And for dessert, try some creamy banana pudding, amazing. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, meat, mesquite, repeat. Make the trip. You won't be sorry. Dine in or take it to go. Go to ericsfamilybbq.com for more info.
Holmberg's Morning Sickness.
Disgusting. They smell. They're sticky. They say things that are horrible. 98.
Only just a year away, Brady, from the Rammstein concert that was supposed to happen 1 year ago. This will be great sometime in 2022 if we're all still alive, because now there's the COVID-19 Moo variant. I don't know if you've heard about this. New or the Moo. Yeah.
No.
Yeah, they identified it a few months ago. Oh, you broke your mic.
Well, there you go.
Wow, that is. Well. Yeah, that one's toast.
Well, he is toast.
Oh, man, you broke the whole thing then.
Yeah, it's done.
Works out perfect. Yeah, you shattered the whole stick. I'll just turn Toledo's mic off. He's done for the day. Works for me. We're done with the word flood. The word dust is coming up, though. 8 o'clock, we'll have that one ready to go for you, and you can get yourself all loaded up. Back to abortions, as I like to say. I'll turn you on there. There you go. Great. Toledo found another mic. Melissa and I are going back and forth. We're on the same page, but she goes, she's got good arguments. She says, why is a woman always called a whore when she's got, I'm like, multiple abortions, you're probably a whore. It's a decision still. But if you've tripled, she goes, I knew a girl who had eight. She said, I think men
eight.
And men, this is her
Whoa.
Argument. Eight. That's a little bit whorish. I think men and women should be made sterile at puberty. Women get an IUD and men get snipped. You pay a small fee to get it reversed, have your kid, and you go right back. We got enough people on this earth. I agree with that wholeheartedly.
With that too.
But we can't get enough people to get a shot in their arm to stop the cold, let alone a mandatory sterilization of teenagers. Although I'd like to watch those fireworks. Texas, you're on the clock. Mandatory sterilization of all prepubescent teens would be phenomenal. Line them up, Texas. I'm sure that'll go great.
Thanks, Orwell.
Yeah. I would love that. Anyway, stop talking to me about abortion. I was making the point.
Hey, right now, as
we shouldn't be talking about
father of a 15-year-old, I'm for mandatory sterilization.
I would imagine so. I've seen your kid. So am I.
Found two condoms in his room.
Oh, you did?
Packaged, yeah. Hey, what do you got those for?
Okay.
I don't know. You don't know? That's the wrong answer. Wrong answer.
By the way,
I don't know.
Before we're done here, Rome just popped in for a second. Jim Rome wants to read a couple of emails. See, great topic. Welcome to the jungle.
Vaccinated or unvaccinated, Rome?
It's not talking about that. Sketchy. Just wanted to come in with the greatest couple of emails I've ever gotten. Dear Rome, I am so for abortion. If not, I would have three kids. All hail abortion. Thunder Horse Porter. That's a real one.
Really?
Thunder Horse. He is down three babies because he spent $1,200 not to have kids.
But is that a good payoff?
Dear Rome, I am moving to Texas and pushing for even more abortion laws. I would like abortions to be legal well into the sixth trimester, signed Toledo's dad.
There we go, yeah.
Give him a good 54-year window. See whether or not your kid is worth it.
Go back in time.
You know what? I'm not ready to be a dad, even though I'm in my 80s. I think it's time he went. So long, son.
Yeah, your pill was going out for smokes.
Dear Rome, go Texas. Hook 'em horns, baby. Signed, Colt McCoy.
What?
Brady went to the
Cardinal
old
quarterback?
Colt McCoy. Texas legend. NFL flameout.
No, he's on the Cardinals, Romy.
Exactly. NFL flameout. Dear Rome, why do you need abortion? Drop in two pumps, then bust out for another state. Signed, Toledo's dad.
Damn it, I didn't see
Pops
that one.
Is on it today.
He's emailing like crazy. And then the clincher. How does no one ever see my things. How can you not support abortion? I dream of having never lived this nightmare. Signed, Caleb from Shriners. Great one out. All right, stop it, Rome.
A snort.
It's the little vacuum after. Anyway, stop it. I'm going to start seeing those, too. Thanks, Texas. Would you be in your 600th trimester? I don't know how trimesters work. When I wrote that down, I'm like, I don't know what a trimester works.
54, let's see. All right, I'll do the math.
What is there, three per pregnancy? Do you get three or four in a pregnancy?
What, trimesters?
Yeah.
That's trimester.
Oh, I guess that would make sense. Yeah. Okay, so that's math again. I'm struggling with that. So you'd be in 100 and you're in your 50s, so you'd be in like
divided
your,
by three. I mean, my 212th trimester.
Okay, so he's way ahead of the game when he put it in the 600th trimester. He might help people in their late hundreds.
Yeah, 150 would be 200 would be 600th.
That's pretty good. That's funny. Anyway, Brady, it's Wings Day.
That's right.
That's right. Hooters bringing you the Brady Report, and it's Wings Day, $16.99 per person for all-you-can-eat wings. And nobody has a problem with all-you-can-eat wings. They're always good. So let's get right on that. All-you-can-eat wings, $16.99 per person. Plus, grab a Bud Light draft on special. Hooters and Bud Light bring you the Brady Report.
Yeah, feeling good on a Wednesday.
On this Wings Day. Brady Report.
Good Wednesday morning to you, Phoenix. Hello, world.
Hi.
Happy American Chess Day. On this day in history is when...
They invented it?
Bobby Fischer.
Chess or chest?
Beat the crap out of that Ruski, Boris Spassky, in the final match. And then he did it in 1992. Whooped his ass again.
All right. Let's not get all ass-whooping with chess.
Ass-whooping.
Don't get too Confederate flag-waving chess fan over there.
David Boy, good
and
old
Bobby Fischer.
Rook to knight straight. That's a big whipping your ass, boy. What you going to do about it now, commie? How's the oligarchy looking today?
Wow, that's a big word for you.
I know. I've been reading. I don't know if I used it right.
Sure, you did.
I know Garky would be good there, though. Like Garky Park.
What are the Arkies? Oh, don't.
Oh, no.
No.
Hey, Garky Park over there. It's like you're struggling with the clock.
A few other things that happened on this day in history on September 1st. 157 years ago in 1864, Yankee General William Sherman, he captured Atlanta.
All right.
82 years ago in 1939, World War II began when Nazi Germany invaded Poland.
Okay.
And then 36 years ago in 1985, the wreck of the Titanic was found 73 years after it sank in the Atlantic
Ocean.
Oh,
they found it on September 1st.
Yep.
It's been that long, though.
When did they find it?
In 85.
85? Oh, that's right. I do remember. Yeah. They didn't bring anything
former
up for
Navy
years,
guy
though.
Teamed up with a French biologist, and they went down. And I remember the little machine called the Argo was that no one was in it at that time.
The unmanned sub, yeah.
They were dropped because they weren't sure if it would collapse under like a tin can under the weight of the water.
And the stuff was spread out over 2 miles. It found, the first thing it found was a boiler.
Mm.
And they go, that's it. And then started scanning the whole thing and.
That was 85.
That's when they figured out it split on its way down. A couple of baseless fun facts. Unfrosted Pop-Tarts have more calories than the frosted Pop-Tarts.
If you're worried about calories, stop eating Pop-Tarts. If you're checking the caloric
because
content.
Thicker.
Okay, Brady, if you're checking the caloric content of a Pop-Tart.
Very important.
You've got a bad diet and you know it. Wonder how much I'm actually putting in my system here of each Pop-Tart. You know, these are the healthier of the Pop-Tarts. Said no one ever.
Means I can eat more of the frosted.
Yeah. I eat the frosted ones. They're better for me. Okay. I'm just going to go get your box. By the way, John Bennett has emailed and said, when Toledo's mic broke, I got excited. John, I, like you, hate those weird little sounds like popcorn bags being rattled in a movie theater. And when I hear Toledo, that same chill runs down my spine. Toledo is my bag of popcorn. Oh, don't do that noise. That will send me.
Miami is the only major American city that was founded by a woman. Her name is Julia Tuttle. She owned a citrus company at the time.
Citrus one.
Yes, she did, Brady.
Company.
You got it right the first time.
Okay.
Cump is a word, too. Used Lutz. For getting in and out of situations quickly.
The largest word in English is 189,819 letters.
Say again?
The longest word in English.
Okay. Go ahead, Brady.
It would take three and a half hours to say.
No, don't let him do that.
We have exactly 3.5 hours left in the show.
Let's go.
It's the chemical name of a protein called titin.
Okay.
Then why don't we just call it titin?
We do.
Yeah.
Didn't you hear him? I know. See, look, bag of popcorn. It's time. You just got to listen.
This is pretty interesting. A new study found that women find more attractive if they mumble a lot.
Women find what more attractive?
Men.
That was an essential word missing from that sentence. Oh, here
new study
go.
Found that women might find men more attractive.
I be smoking. Oh, no. That's what I be doing.
Were you the one with the...
It came on the jukebox when I was at the bar, and I didn't play it. I was
really?
Like, you got to be kidding. I looked around for Brady.
Was he on the ground?
Cowboy hat on, saddled up.
You have mango margies?
Oh, that guy's having a stroke.
I was in a twink bar, pal.
Researchers recorded 42 people speaking and had a separate group rate how attractive their voices were. People who mumble tend to blend their vowels together.
You.
So they ran all the audio through a program that looked at speech patterns and how far apart different vowel sounds were. And they found that guys who mumbled a lot got higher ratings than men who spoke clearly and were easier to understand. The opposite was true for female voices, though. Men thought the women who spoke clearly were more attractive.
Yeah, I don't want to hear some chick mumbling the whole time. But women pay attention to, like, when a man talks. That's the difference. So if a girl, man, she gets a thing on those things.
What did he say? He's so mysterious.
And if I say, hey, you do look a little fat in those jeans, she's going to understand me.
The National Confectioners Association says 82% of people they surveyed plan to celebrate Halloween one way or another this year. They also looked and asked people how they ate candy corn. Okay. 80%
There's a method?
Yeah.
With my mouth is the answer? I don't know. Like, you bite little bits off?
Yeah.
You eat by the color?
You had 52% eat the whole piece at once, 31% bite off the narrow end first, and then do the
By the way,
the base.
Back to the mumbling men thing.
Yeah.
And I'm living this because Megan has just changed her hair. And she's convinced, like, the dogs noticed.
They're mumbling?
Because I think she's like, well, because it's kind of a new look, and it's like she went to this thing. And like, if I mumble right now, if I'm like, well, it's just the bangs.
Are you talking about my bangs?
Yes. Of course I am. So then I came in the house yesterday, sitting there, and she goes,
Jack noticed my bangs.
Jack did not notice your hair.
Yeah, he looked right at him. He's like, something's different.
I'm like, you're self-conscious of your hair because it's new to you. So you think that even the dogs are not.
He did. He knew it.
She had a bandage on her head for a while because she doesn't listen. And that's a good one. And then so.
He noticed the bandage.
Yeah, because you had a big lump of thing on your head. Of course he's going to notice that. But he doesn't know hair. He doesn't know what bangs are. And then I sit in the corner and just...
You're talking about my bangs.
So that's why women like a mumbler is because they assume he notices the one thing they're most insecure about at that moment. His dick's nipples are all over.
Did you say something about my nipples being hard?
No. Of course I didn't. You know, understand me.
Next week, Bud Light is releasing their fall season flavored seltzers. They're getting into the pumpkin spice thing. Each 12-pack has 4 different flavors. Pumpkin spice, maple pear, apple crisp, and toasted marshmallow.
Yuck.
Yeah, enough.
Nothing appealing.
No.
A new poll asked...
Gut bomb after gut bomb.
A new poll asked 27,000 Americans, is the left lane for passing or driving fast? Most popular answer...
Depends.
Was both. 40%
two-lane highway or multi-lane highway?
Yeah. 36% say it should only be used for passing. And 13% say it's mainly for people who want to drive faster than the flow of traffic.
It's hard to argue that it's not the fastest of lanes. It's the unwritten rule that we've made it that.
You always pass on the left.
And going back to the abortion thing with, you know, comparing it to driving, I got an email from Lee, and it said the best way to avoid having to deal with pregnancy is to not put yourself in situations where you can get pregnant. And it's undeniable logic. It's just something you can't fight, but it's also something that can't be done. If it were true that you could tell the general public, here's a logical answer to a problem, and we all went, yep, absolutely, we wouldn't need speed limits. It would be
nice
to have freeways where everybody was reasonable and thoughtful and understanding of the way things work. But if you said there's no speed limit, it would be all hell would break loose. People would do whatever they wanted. So, yeah, it's a great email, but we have to have laws. When we're moving 2 tons of metal at 70 miles an hour, we have to make sure everybody's on the same page or we'll kill each other thinking we have the right to do it. So they put limits on everything. I wish we could be logical and responsible. I wish we could all say, you know what, this is probably the best idea for everybody. But no. And I'd be a guilty party if they had no speed limits.
Imagine back
flying up.
Wasn't that long ago when the resistance on passing the law to wear a seatbelt.
Oh yeah, well.
Oh yeah. That one and then mandatory insurance, you know, and all that.
Yeah, it's undeniable. And it would be, like Lee says, he emailed me, very smart. So not trying to argue, but the choice to avoid pregnancy is the choice to make. Humanity of a baby doesn't change. You're absolutely right. Who can argue that? But people aren't smart enough, so we're going to have a problem. So basically it's like saying we shouldn't have rules on the road because everybody understands the danger of putting a car in motion. But we have to have rules on the road because nobody cares about the danger of putting a car in motion.
I've got a quick pee-pee poo-poo news.
Oh, good.
Oh, boy. It's going to take a second.
He told me to.
Oh, it's on you. Bag of popcorn.
I can push it back one story.
No. You got it?
It's coming.
Oh. Don't push it back. Make him sit in
his own
stew. I've got
a quick pee-pee poo-poo news.
Don't keep saying it. Just let him sit in his own stew. There you go.
Hello, my friends. I'm Brady Bogan, and this is your pee-pee poo-poo news.
I didn't even know about it. I was ready with the farts.
Some guy on Vancouver Island in Canada walked into a Dairy Queen on Saturday night, and they asked him to put his mask on, but he refused. Claimed he was exempt, didn't have to wear one, but they wouldn't serve him. So he said, "Pardon me while I whip this out."
Oh boy!
Oh no!
And started peeing on the counter. Guy behind him in line got it on video, but you don't see anything graphic. You just hear him arguing with the staff. Several female employees started screaming when they see what he's doing.
Sure. Tends to elicit a scream.
Not into the Mr. Misty!
Yeah, pissing at a Dairy Queen.
He eventually zipped up.
I'd scream like
called
a woman.
Them psychos. And,
for the record, no, it's not my boys. Neither one of them are working at Dairy Queen. Currently.
Are they both out?
Yep.
Uh-oh. Moving on to bigger, better things?
That was the idea, Brett.
Oh,
where no. do you, when are you going to go to Panda Express, right?
Panda Express doesn't hire till 16. He could have figured that out before he tried going.
But he quit.
Yeah.
To go work at Panda Express.
Yeah. And what happened to the idiot? What happened to the power move at Andy's?
Andy's also doesn't hire until 16.
Oh.
All easily things you could have figured out before applying and quitting.
All right. Yell at him. Stop yelling at us for your mistakes. That abortion law in Texas is pissing Toledo off, and it's years down the road.
That's your pee-pee poo-poo news.
It makes you respect your dad, though, doesn't it? His decisions. He was on to something.
Yeah, I suppose.
I'd like to talk to him about that.
Yeah, I understand. Just call him up and go, dude, I'm not even
here.
We're
good. We're good.
I totally understand what you did. Totally get it. I got one now. And
we're good, bro. If I was half the asshole that he is right now, I apologize.
Yeah.
A 22-year-old Florida man, Taylor Beverly is his name. He was on a date and had his date hop on his motorcycle, and at one point he ran a red light.
Uh-oh.
Then he saw a cop at the intersection. Cop turned on his lights. Taylor did not stop. He sped up well over 100 miles per hour, weaved in and out of traffic, ran several other red lights. He eventually was caught. He told the cops he was trying to show off for his date. Woman told the cops that she was screaming the whole time, "Please stop!"
Yeah.
He was charged with a felony of fleeing the cops. He was released on $10,000 bond. His previous rap sheet includes convictions for cocaine possession, grand theft, passing a counterfeit check.
And he was immediately hired as the athletic director of Bishop Sycamore in Ohio.
Same guy.
Same guy. That story's getting better and better. Ohio. Sorry, Brady.
Oh,
your state is brutally
in
funny.
Columbus.
Did
too.
You see? Did and the, did you see in the news a couple days ago? A guy reporting from Mississippi's shore on the hurricane. Some other guy pulls his truck over, runs up, and starts going. You report him, yeah. Ohio man.
Yeah,
wanted. He's in Mississippi, yeah. Yelling at the news guy.
Yeah,
and he's from
on
Ohio.
Probation.
And
so they finally got him.
Well, yeah, and he's not allowed to travel. They know who he is, and he's got like all these warrants and stuff because he's an Ohio.
Good.
Man. Yeah, Ohio man down in Mississippi. And genius pulls over.
Working his way to Florida.
On, of course. That's where
a little off.
Where Ohio summers.
That's the directions in Ohio are that bad?
South and then
for
go
him.
To the, and then go turn
till you hit water.
Turn left to water.
Yeah.
Otherwise you might have been an Alabama.
We have a winner, our first winner.
All right.
Charisma Kramer of
Charisma.
Phoenix.
Have we met Charisma? I think she emails.
That does sound familiar.
Congratulations, Charisma. The 8 o'clock word is dust. You can start texting that now for $1,000. 97936. We're buying your affection every hour. Dust is the word. 97936. Hop on that thing right now. Text it over to us. KUPD Nation broke the big national contest. We are our own sovereign contest now. $6,000 a day for just KUPD listeners while the others toil around in their national contest. Nice job, gang. Dust. The Bobs actually said, next time we have a contest, could you make it so a whole lot less people participate.
What the hell's
that's
the
how big KUP is. Yeah, they were laughing about it. They're like, could you just pull back on the whole participation thing? Like, well, I can't. There are a mountain of people out there that love us. Dust, go get them.
San Francisco will begin to pay people not to shoot other people.
Hey. Oh, well, that's nice.
I should be a millionaire.
We should all be
kidding.
The Dreamkeeper Fellowship is the program. They picked out 12 criminal groups and gangs. And they said, we'll pay you $300 a month.
Man.
And a month. All because the shootings went up. And they're an all-time 56-year low in 2019. Pandemic comes in, and they gradually started.
So everybody from Chicago is just going to move out
Toledo,
to San
let
Francisco.
Me tell you, I don't know how you side with that political party. I really don't. I don't side with either. And I probably lean more one way than the other. But when this kind of stuff happens, San Francisco is the fastest way to make everybody go, I don't want to be a liberal. 100%. I think I'll just say I'm nothing.
They said Pookie will get $300 a month.
How in the
and
world?
And you can receive up to $200 extra if you hit certain milestones, like getting a job interview.
Is it taxpayer money that we pay people not to shoot others now?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Dreamkeeper Fellowship. Absolutely.
And they call it the Dreamkeeper.
Fellowship. Yeah, figure out where that's funded from.
You know, San Francisco might be the worst place in the entire country. I'd rather live in South Chicago because I think those people have more logic than I would ever in San Francisco, where it just gets weirder and weirder with the let's coddle the worst elements of society into they try to win hearts and minds constantly. It's like your grandma being in charge of like the special ed class. She's going to lose her mind. Keep trying to give them cookies. They don't listen. How about you shoot someone, we shoot you? There's a rule. Instead of giving you a couple $100 for a good day without murder. Did you murder anybody today? No. You're a dream keeper. The dream remains alive for everyone, at least in your path, because you didn't shoot anyone today. Oh, it's been 3 days since my last shooting. I got $900 in my pocket.
I had 6 months bullet free. I was $1,800 in, man.
I bought this house because I stopped shooting people. Brilliant. San Francisco is cesspool of just illogical nonsense. It makes me want to like be part of Fox News. That's how bad San Francisco is. Makes me want to be Tucker Carlson's best friend. Because if it means hanging out with the other side, I'll take Tucker.
I got a couple of Wild America stories.
All right, I'm ready.
Hello, my friends. I'm Brady Bogan, and this is your Wild America. The two big fires that are happening in Tahoe, in the state of Nevada.
And California.
And California.
Joined the fire.
Caldor fire. And it's pretty amazing. It's getting close to Tahoe, and they're getting everyone evacuated. But they've brought down the snowmakers, and they started using those.
Oh, they're chunking
the
snow. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
And we can get
hopefully
a little skiing.
Hopefully that gets
in
a little more, and they get some of this rain, too. I don't know what the But they have forecast in the next.
The only time I was in Tahoe, they had a forest fire up by Donner Pass. It wasn't a big one. Man, it smoked up that little valley real fast.
And former NHL goalie Pete Peters is in the record books for fishing. He has now the world's largest cod, the world's largest sturgeon in British Columbia.
Is he a professional fisherman or is this just a goof?
I think he fishes pretty regularly, but I don't know if he's this was a pro tournament.
You know how I know hockey's
cooler
than fishing?
He goes, he's never fished this river before. But right.
You know how I know hockey is cooler than fishing? Because when you're a professional fisherman, if you used to play hockey, people say you were you're an ex-hockey player before they say you're a fisherman.
He did use a good guide, Kevin Estrada. He runs Sturgeon Slayers, and they caught a 11-foot-6-inch sturgeon weighing 890 pounds.
Wow.
They released, but there's sturgeon? A little kind of...
I don't know.
That one you're catching and releasing.
You are?
Yeah, because I don't think there's a ton of them out there.
There aren't?
No.
Then why are you fishing for them?
Yeah.
Good fight. Looking for a good fight for the day.
I'll give you $300 to stop fighting the sturgeon. Please stop fighting the endangered sturgeon.
That makes almost as much sense as being paid to shoot people
gonna kill
in San
you.
Francisco.
I got my gun out. I'm thinking about, but you know what? If I shoot you, I lose my money. That is, their logic is that the person will then go, well, I'll lose my check. Not, I'll go to jail for the rest of my life or anything else.
That's true with most sport fishing.
Stop shooting?
No, the catch and release.
Yeah, a lot of them. They don't need it. They'd be eating all day. Yeah, because that Gary Yamamoto that lived here caught like 600 bass a week. The guy was out there throwing bass. If he was eating them, we'd have nothing but bass for dinner every day. One of those pro fishermen lived over by Dobson High when I went there. It was a Japanese guy. It wasn't Yamamoto, but
oh, yeah.
It was another dude. That guy had every day he went out and fished and came back with, you know, I was like 13. We hit our limit. We put them all back. Like, he was an amazing bat. My dad's friend Howard was trying to be a professional fisherman, would hang out at this dude's house, whether he wanted him to or not. It's like Brady, just stood in his yard until he came outside.
What's going on?
Yeah.
That's your wild America.
Okay, sorry.
We'll end it with a couple of quick radio videos.
All right.
First one is a beauty, a real beauty, John.
You don't know what
it is,
do you?
Quickie. Yeah, no, it's a bike. This is for the...
he had to remember. He had to remember.
Excellent description.
A bike
so far.
Jump.
Okay. Okay, there you go. Oh, he's a bike jump.
Loses the bike at the end.
Oh, my
now they'll do it from a different angle.
Yeah, he's jumping a massive downhill.
Oh, man.
Oh, he's going to need to go to Action Ride Show and get a whole new setup.
Oh. He'd make that on a pivot.
No, he wouldn't. Nobody would make him do that.
Oh.
You'll make that if you have wings. If you're a bat, you might not make that.
Now, Ryan Bryan from Action might make that one. That's about it.
No.
Sick.
This is sick, kid. You just watched your daddy die.
This is sick. Coolest dead by daddy. I'm going home.
That's how Toledo's dad left.
Yep.
Does he have E.T. in his basket in the front? It didn't work.
Yeah. Should have flown. This guy.
This thing is useless. Stupid little lump of alien.
This guy's using the Flying V lawn cut. He's got his riding mower. And
what? Yes. Cousin fucking.
Oh my God. I forgot about that.
Brady, the guy said cousin effer. That's the first
time. My audio didn't come on.
Well, look at that hillbilly's doing. Of course he's going to say
got,
that.
He's made a lawnmower marching band. He's got
Flying
six
V.
Six lawnmowers tied behind his riding mower to mow more. That's kind of a neat idea. How's he keeping them so on point?
Yeah, that's especially around the tree.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. But what in cousin hell is going on here? It's not something we can say.
That's after he's cutting.
All right, turn it off so I can turn that back up. What in cousin effing blah, blah, blah.
There you have it.
All right, that's it. Well done. The word is dust. Dust is today's word. 97936. You text that. You might win $1,000. You got till 840 to text dust, DUST, for those of you who are just as stupid as a log. Dust, that's it. 97936. There you go. There goes your Brady Report. Brought to you by Hooters and Bud Light.
It's out of control now.
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness Podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, Repeat, ericsfamilybbq.com.